got three poems for you tonight. I'm going to read them in the order in which they were written. And the last one was written today, and it's pretty ugly, so I'm going to start with the earliest ones. This is one of the earliest poems that I felt I did a really good job on, which was way back in high school. And it's got all my summer angst in it. It was before I quite heard my, had found my voice, so it was a little bit more slam than my usual style. It's called Sunnydays. I'm stuck in the fucking sunshine, half alive and three quarters dying. It takes all my hard-earned cash just to buy me a reason. Some find the summer season pleasing, but I can't see their reason. I'll tell you what we know, and I tell you what I think I know. And if you speak without contractions, I will tell you so. The day's been dry and empty, and the sky's been bold, and I have tried to see as others see. There will be time, I'm fine. Look outside, the lines of vines march swiftly, and the clouds are fine, as tufts of wool that tangle on the tips of thorns. Just give me room. The vacant moon can still be found, though drawn in blue, and I'm alone, and there is you. There's nothing we can do until we're two, and I as yet am halfway dead and three quarters alive. Given time, I'll thrive. And the second is a celebration of how cool Sowbugs are, basically. Some facts and true experiences, and they're just very cute. It's called Sowbug. Sowbug, I have crunched your body raw and found it foul. Noble mulcher, woodlouse, I have caught you in grass bottles, seen you crawl free, your orange pulp feet on glass which has no friction. Sowbug, you filled my trailer with gray life and sought escape. Non-invasive force, you do not even deign to touch my scraps. Funneler of water through your tail, crustacean needing all that you have left. Pillbug, you who rolls but cannot funnel, you who snaps into a pellet, whose shell is gunship gray, you who are mistaken for the sowbug, you must live in damper places, you who I have seen and loaned and flicked and made a marble of. Sowbug, who swims in air when logs are lifted, born of shrimp and crab, land creature, science does not care to know you. Sowbug, pillbug, gray and humble, I have felt your soft feet creep across my childish hands. I know that you have rhythm, native swimmer, living in the dark but out of water. I have jarred you with a scorpion for days and seen it starve. And this third poem has not been titled yet. This is a much uglier poem that I've composed just today, so I haven't even done a second draft yet, but it's a response to recent events and generally the history of the country. The spirit of our nation had her feet sliced, striding over fields of broken bones. Her hands bled and blistered, wielding bullwhips. She barely put a band-aid on these wounds. She felt so bold and optimistic, so they festered, blood and pus marking her hand and footprints, going septic. Now we're bloodsick, soul-sick, with a fever that we barely noticed that we felt before. The fever has a leader, but to kill him would increase the sickness more. She's wounded freshly by the clawing fingernails of children who'll never see their parents anymore. The fever is brain melting, woozy collapsing. She manifests her destiny all in the pools of blood and vomit that she leaves upon the floor.